Hey guys, John Gorby from Elmore Music, and this month I'm going to be looking at a question that you guys had regarding a very problematic area in your playing. Now, some time ago, we sent out a survey asking you, out of all the concepts that you have to deal with in your playing, what's the one concept that you have the most difficulty with? And the overwhelming response was changing chords. And this is something I see day in and day out in my own teaching, and it's something that I'm sure you're having a problem with. So this month, I'm going to address that. I'm going to talk about some things that you're probably doing wrong, and I'm going to also show you some ways you can correct that as well. So let's get started. So first I want to start with an A minor chord. Alright, you probably know this very well. If not, it's right above my shoulder. You can check that out. Alright, but there's an A minor chord. Now, what I want to do with this is move this to an E chord. Okay? And I'm going to show you two examples here. This one is going to talk about holding the shape, keeping your fingers close to the strings. Alright? First two things I want you to focus on here with this lesson. Holding the shape by keeping your fingers together and keeping your fingers close to the strings as you make the transition. So, here's the A minor. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to keep the shape, I'm going to move my fingers up one set of strings. And there's my E chord. And there's my A minor again. So you can see why this is a really great example. It's the same shape. I don't have to really change anything. Just move the location of the shape. But that's the first thing that you want to do, is be able to hold that shape together, keep your fingers together. Now, one of the things that a lot of players do, beginner players and even intermediate players, is what they'll do is when they go to change, they'll move these fingers around and try to place them back down again on the strings, which is, you know, the one thing you don't want to do because it takes too much time, expends too much energy, and it just complicates the process. If you're trying to play in time to a song, that'll never happen. So when you practice this, grab the A minor, and then if you want, don't even worry about the right hand. Just see if you can hold the shape, keep your fingers close, and then move to the chord, move to the E chord. And then when you have the E chord established, move it back down to the A minor again. Okay, and then of course you can put in some strum patterns and start working on those. Okay, now the next thing here I want to deal with, next concept, is the idea of gliding your fingers along each other. Alright, so we're going to grab, say, the E minor now. Alright, there's an E minor shape. I think we all know that one. And what we're going to do here is, step one, is we're going to take 2 and 3 finger and move it down to the 4th and 3rd string. Now let me back up for just 1 second here, because it's real important to realize too that I could have played this with my 1st and 2nd finger. Alright, still an E minor chord. However, because of where I'm going to an A minor chord, so I want to set up for that. So it's going to be a lot more work if I go from E minor to A minor, and I'll show you that in just a moment. But first, let's go back to 2 and 3. So step one, like I said, we're just going to work on moving this shape down one set of strings. So from strings 5 and 4, I'm going to be on strings 4 and 3. And then back up again. Again, try to keep contact with the strings even if you can. Feel them under your fingers so you see exactly how far you have to pick them up. It's not very far. Okay, the next thing I want you to look at here, see if you can see this here in the second camera. As I place my fingers down, I'm gliding my first finger along my second. Alright, so that's the next thing I want you to think about. It's gliding your fingers along each other. In this case, it's just really the first finger. It's keeping contact with the second finger, right, that knuckle. Real important, keep contact with it, right, that knuckle. And then glide it along and glide it down into the second string. Okay, by doing that, it helps to kind of guide it to the second string so it doesn't have a mind of its own, just go wherever it wants to go, right? The one thing you don't want to do, lift your fingers up, move your first finger way out here, happens a lot, you might do it, and then place it down. And then when you move back up again, you know, too much movement. So E minor to A minor should just look like this. Okay. So we just did two chords here, all right? Let me give you a third, okay? Let's say we're going from an E minor to an A minor. And now we want to go to C. All you have to move is that third finger. That's it. Because your second finger and your first finger have the same notes in common between those two chords, A minor and C. So the third finger stays very close to the second finger. It doesn't just come way out here, right? It stays very close, glides along the second finger, and goes right up on that third string. So A minor, and there's a C. So you can see that this way. So it stays very, very, very close. Now let's go back again, and let's talk about why I didn't want to play the E minor with the first and second finger. All right, this is another problem. It's using, I don't want to say an incorrect fingering, but using an inefficient fingering that makes more work for yourself to get to the next chord. Here's the E minor with one and two. Now I have to put my third finger down, and then take my first finger and place that down, right? So it's really like two motions now going on. Eventually it'll be one motion, but two actions. This one, E minor, now your third finger goes down, and the first finger goes down. First finger has to come way up over top, and the third finger has to lift up to go back to the E minor again. So even though it can be done, it's okay. I'd rather take this route. It just feels better. It's less cumbersome, and you know there won't be any errors. You won't have any fumbling around to do. It'll be easier. Okay, so it's all about efficiency. Holding the shape if you can, gliding your fingers along each other, guiding them into their proper place on the strings and in the frets, and keeping your fingers close to the strings as well, and repetition, repetition, repetition. Practiced with enough repetition, those three concepts, you shouldn't have any problems. You should be able to master really any chord transition and feel better about your playing. All right, so that's going to make your playing a lot smoother right there. All right, so this month it's all about changing chords. Go grab your guitar, get to work. Have fun. I'll see you next month.